September 16th, 1757 A.M. The covering of the ark removed by Noah on the first day of the first month, answering to our September 16th. See November 2nd. 322 B.C. Demosthenes, the Grecian orator, died by poison, on the most mournful day of the Thesmophoria, 16th of Pyanepsion. 36. Herod Agrippa thrown into bonds at Rome by Tiberius. 655. Martin the First, Pope, died. He caused the doctrines of the monothelites to be condemned, and was afterwards sent to the Crimea by Constantine, where he died of ill treatment. 1186. A conjunction of all the planets at sunrise in Libra, on which occasion the astrologers had predicted great calamities. 1380. Charles V the Wise, of France, died. By his abilities and energy, the English were dispossessed of nearly all their provinces in France. 1519. John Colet, an English divine, died, known as the founder of St. Paul's School, London, for the gratuitous education of 153 pupils perpetually. His father had 22 children, yet at the time of making the above endowment, he had no near relative to inherit the property. 1589. Michael Baius, an able French ecclesiastic, died. His writings are superior to the learning of the times in which he lived. 1655. The Swedish settlement on the Delaware, called Fort Casimir, commanded by Swenskots, surrendered to the Dutch under Governor Stuyvesant. Place consisted of 4 14-pounders, 5 swivels and some small arms, which were delivered to the conquered, who became possessed of the west side of Delaware Bay, and the fortress was called New Amstel by the Dutch, and New Castle by the English. 1681. Action off Cape Spartel between a British ship and an Algerian corsair with 327 men and 88 Christian slaves on board. M. within pistol shot, and was renewed again next morning, when the corsair, having lost 2 masts, called for quarter. 1686. Ficon Gonor died at Aberclawrk, in Wales, aged 140. 1786. 1701. James II, of England, died in France. He was dethroned in 1688, and remained a pensioner on the bounty of the King of France till his death. 1732. The tide in the River Thames, England, flowed 8 hours instead of 4 and ebbed 5 instead of 8. 1736. Gabriel Daniel Fahrenheit, a Prussian philosopher, died, eminent for his great improvement in the construction of thermometers. 1745. Bergen op Zoom surrendered to the French. 1775. Alan Bathurst, an English statesman, died. His biographers claim for him almost every talent and every virtue. 1776. Unsuccessful attack of the British on the Americans at Harlem Heights. British lost 20 killed and about 100 wounded. 1779. Count D'Estaing summoned Savannah, Georgia, garrisoned by the British under General Provost, who amused the French until he received a reinforcement. 1782. Carlo Broschi Farinelli died, an Italian singer of great celebrity. 1784. Robert Bell the First, who kept a circulating library in Philadelphia, died at Richmond, Virginia. 1785. Darkness so great at Quebec that no person could read at noonday. See October 16, 1783. 1792. 3,000 French refugees had landed in England from the Revolution in France, and in the course of the following year they were reckoned at 8,000 priests and 2,000 laymen. These were mostly destitute, and down to 1806, about £2 million had been contributed to their support. 1795, Cape of Good Hope surrendered to the British by the Dutch. 1800, Battle of Lambok. The French took from the Austrians 1,000 wagons of provisions, equipage and ammunition. 1804, William Tyndall, an English divine and antiquary, died. 1805, an experiment with a calamarin made on a vessel of 300 tons burden opposite Wam Castle, England, which succeeded and blew up the vessel. 1808, Peter Isaac Theluson, a rich London merchant, died, leaving £500,000 to accumulate till the male children of his grandsons are dead, which may extend to 120 years from his death, when it will amount to £140 million, and if there should be no lineal descendants, it goes to the benefit of the sinking fund. 1824. Louis XVIII, of France, died. During the reign of Napoleon, he lived in England. He is represented as a mild and amiable prince, who consulted the wishes and happiness of his people. 1833. Calvin Edson, the living skeleton, died. His weight was about 40 pounds. 1833. The boundary line between New York and New Jersey settled. 1834. William Blackwood died in Edinburgh, eminent as a bookseller and publisher of the well-known periodical, Blackwood Magazine. 1838. The entire railway from London to Birmingham opened, when the passage including stoppages of 34 minutes was performed in 4 hours, 48 minutes. 1839. The expedition under Dease and Simpson regained the Coppermine River after the longest voyage that had ever been performed by boats in the Polar Sea. 1631. Statute Miles. On the return of the party from the Red River settlement to England, Simpson perished by violence, but was more fortunate than Park or Hudson, in leaving behind him his own record of his own achievements. 1848. John P. Cushman, an American jurist, died at Troy, New York, aged 64. He was born in Connecticut, graduated at Yale, and commenced the practice of law in Troy. He held various offices of trust, and was eminent in his profession. 1848. The populace of Frankfurt attempted an insurrection, but were quelled. Prince Lichnowsky and Major von Auerswald were barbarously murdered by insurgents outside of the walls. 1851. Henry Whiting, an American general, died at St. Louis. He began his military career in 1808, and was among the oldest officers of the army. He served with reputation on the Niagara frontier, and in the war with Mexico, sharing in the glory of the field of Buena Vista. He was a contributor to the Northam Review. 1852. Earthquake in Manila and places adjacent, which continued until 18 October, doing great damage. 1854. Lucerne Ray, an American poet, died at Hartford, Connecticut, aged 43. After graduating at Yale, he became a teacher in the Deaf and Dumb Institution at Hartford, where he found time to edit the Religious Herald, and the first 6 volumes of Annals of the Deaf and Dumb, to write poetry, and collect materials for A History of New England. 1855. Benedetto Pistrucci, medalist to the Queen of England, died at Windsor, aged 73. He was a member of various learned European institutions.